Hi, EJ. That was a very, very interesting video about that the book, The Twelfth Planet. I looked at the video last night on Thursday night, and I'm doing this on Friday evening, so I think I've got everything right. The whole genre or subgenre of cosmology with books about aliens from other planets, you know, a la Chariots of the Gods, an incredibly popular seller in the 70s, late 60s or early 70s. There's always something else that we'd like to be involved, I think, in the creation of the universe and all of that sort of stuff. But I don't discount really anything besides a lot of the Bible. And even some of that, of course, based in history as opposed to dogma is probably truthful, at least there's grains of salt in that too. The 12th planet, I don't know if I buy into the premise as explained by you so much as I actually find it all very exciting to contemplate that it might be true. The concept also of the singularity of humanity, you know, why are we like this, why are we the sentient beings, the ones that know that we will die and things like that, you know, like was that seeded from a greater intelligence? You know, how did we evolve to be, in theory, the masters of the planet, which of course we know that instead of stewardship, we've ravaged it. So there's, you know, there's different theories on that, of course, too. But I do find that topic interesting. I always find that topic interesting. And I think it's super. I mean, you advocated very well for that book. I think it's going to get a lot more sales because of your video. Pardon me. I don't know if I'll get around to reading it because I've read similar material years ago, I think, of that, what I call that genre, you know. And I always wanted to either be abducted by aliens or have them land in my backyard or something. So it's like I have a wish that there is something else around besides, you know, plasma out there in the eons of space and so on. So when you start investigating what you've done, when you start investigating things like, what is it, Machu Picchu or Michu Panchu or something like that. I can never get that right. The place in Peru. And, you know, what was the point of that place? And, you know, the whole concept of Atlantis, where was it? I think it did exist in some way. And you get a Space Odyssey, 2001 A Space Odyssey, you know, that had an interesting theme. There's just, you know, it's just countless in fiction and in nonfiction, speculative fiction, whatever. So I think it's always a theme that will be with us. I hope we're around past 2012. I do have my copy of the Mayan calendar on the wall there that I picked up in Mexico. I don't know how to interpret it, but it's really quite weird to think that instead of being from Eastern Canada, in my case, or from Europe, in your case, you're actually from Pluto or something, you know, like, it's all so interesting, isn't it, you know, talk about ancestors in your attic. I think that's a show that we have here. Anyway, very, very strong video, and I hope that you can find time to do one for movies, or more than one. You're welcome to do more than one. Every video gets an entry. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Michael from the Red Chair Diaries.